What's up? I'm Jordan. Everybody was really excited when Figma released what they called Dev Mode earlier this year, but there was already a big player in the design handoff industry named Zeplin. So I did a deep dive looking at these two tools and doing a ton of research, figuring out their general approach to handoff, their feature set, their pricing, everything. And I was kind of surprised at what I found. So today I'm going to show you the important differences between the two tools and then give you my take on which kinds of teams should use each one. Big thanks to Zeplin for sponsoring our look into the handoff industry, but just want to be clear that we did all the research and we are the ones who came up with the final results. It goes without saying that handoff is an extremely important part of your work as a product designer. And the good news is that both of these tools have the same fundamental features that make this a lot easier. Both of them allow you to mark designs as ready for developers. Developers can get auto-generated specs, and you can play around with component variants and states. It's worth noting that you're also going to pay for both because starting in January 2024, Figma Dev Mode is going to require that you pay for dev accounts. Zeplin's pricing starts at $8 a month and Figma Dev Mode will start at $12 a month. The key differences between Figma Dev Mode and Zeplin are in how they go about doing these things. So let's take a look at that. I'm going to start by explaining a couple of the things that Figma Dev Mode is particularly good at. First one, you probably could have guessed, it's the fact that it's integrated with your design tool. If your design team uses Figma, it's very nice to have everything in one place. Adding another tool to your lineup that you have to pay for and learn and use on a regular basis can be a legitimate big deal for some teams. So it's really nice that the handoff features are baked into a tool that your team is already using. The second point here is that Figma Dev Mode is a little more flexible in terms of process. Zeplin has a very opinionated way of going about doing things, as I'll show in a minute. And if the way that you work doesn't fall in line with that, then it could be kind of frustrating to use. Dev Mode, on the other hand, is a bit less opinionated. You have the foundational tools that you need to make handoff better, and if you do handoff in a unique way, you have a little more wiggle room to roll with whatever your team's process happens to be. Figma also has an excellent Visual Studio Code extension. You can open and inspect Figma designs right in VS Code itself, which could be really nice for devs. Zeplin has one too, but it's not as robust or helpful. So again, if your devs use VS Code, this could be a really nice selling point. Okay, so let's dig into the things that make Zeplin stand out here. The first major pro for Zeplin is in how you can define when a design is ready for development and also indicate that there are different versions of it. In dev mode, you mark a section or frame as ready for dev. That's great in some respects, but the main issue with this is that the section or the frame where you mark something as final and ready for handoff is the same place that you're going to be doing your active ongoing design work. And versioning can be a bit tricky to work around. Dev Mode has an excellent compare changes interface, but nothing really prevents ongoing changes while someone is reviewing that. And you can't work on a draft frame somewhere else in your Figma file and then paste it into the ready for dev version because that actually resets the version history. So let's take a relatively common example. Let's say you finish a design for version 1 of a new feature and mark it as ready for dev. But while the devs get started building out this version 1, you need to start working on the design for version 2 right away. So what do? You can make an entirely new frame for version 2 and either mark that as ready for dev or paste the designs into the original frame. But like I just mentioned, you'll lose the ability for developers to compare changes between the two versions. Or you could start working on version 2 right there in the same frame, but that makes things way more complicated for everyone because you have to communicate to the developers which part you're working on and which part of the file is actually final. So it can get kind of messy and complicated. In Zeplin, you export the design file, the screen, into Zeplin, a separate tool, where it is locked and documented. This way the developer knows for certain that what they're looking at is the final file they need to be working on, and they can comfortably go about doing their work without worrying about whether or not it's going to change in the middle of the build. It's an abstracted outside source of truth instead of allowing them to dig into your workspace, so your two workflows are separate. Versioning in Zeplin is pretty nice also. It's structured similar to Git if you're familiar with that. So you do all your exploratory design work in your design tool, And when you're ready, you submit an updated design with a description. Then stakeholders approve that design, and then it gets published for developers as a new locked version with detailed tracking showing what changed between this version and the previous one. The whole process just feels way more clear, precise, and straightforward to me. Next thing I wanted to go over is file organization. I've heard a lot of times from developers that they find it difficult to navigate the infinite canvases in Figma. Not to mention that final files are also alongside the messy working files that you inevitably generate while you're designing, so it can be hard for them to find exactly what they're looking for. Now, you can mitigate that problem for them a little just by having clean, organized Figma files. But I really like some of the features of Zeplin for file organization. They have folders so that you can group up design files by things like features or sprints. They have tags so you can categorize design files by things like project, team member, or status. And they have a pretty good global search and filters to help you find specific files or even comments and annotations across all your projects. This is much easier to navigate and helps you find what you need quickly and efficiently. Another thing I wanted to mention here is that Zeplin has a really nice user flow feature. Figma has prototyping mode and plugins for user flows, but I find those things to be a bit fiddly. Zeplin's user flows have dynamic connectors and labels and shapes that move with your screens and that are separate from the actual design elements. And those things are kind of hard or maybe even impossible to get in Figma. You can gather up user flows into flow groups and boards and then easily share those. And others can still drill down into the specific screens and get all the details they need there. It's just organized within a clean user flow context. Figma obviously has tons of design system tools, but as far as the dev handoff process goes, I think Zeplin wins out for a few reasons. You can connect your design system to the team's code with links to things like Storybook, GitHub, and VS Code. Zeplin also centralizes everything into a style guide. So when a dev clicks on a design element, they'll be able to see not only all the specs, but also other information like usage across your project, and links to the component and instructions within the context of the whole style guide. And you can more easily see and play around with component states and variants. So what's the verdict here? Which tool should your team use? Here's my take. Ultimately, it's important to remember that Figma is first and foremost a design tool that has now added some features for improved handoff. Zeplin is a purpose-built, separate environment specifically made for handoff. So in my opinion, Figma Dev Mode is best for teams that are pretty dedicated to Figma and don't want to add another tool to their stack, which is a legitimate concern. These are probably going to be smaller, newer teams that are still trying to finalize their handoff process. The flexibility and integrated nature of Dev Mode may work better for them. Zeplin is good for larger or more mature teams who have established processes and a decent number of stakeholders involved. It's also better for more complex projects and when you want more control over the handoff process. The better experience for designers and developers and the more robust tools make Zeplin a good option for those teams, even though you'll need to add another tool to your lineup. What do you think? Did I miss anything? Let us know in the comments. And if you want to see some alternatives to Figma for UI design, check out this video from Taylor where he sizes up 11 different options.